Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. Dear viewers, welcome back again. We were talking about, or we're discussing around father's role in the upbringing of the kids, inshallah. If you want to share your experience, your ideas, you can call in. I'm going to go back to Robert again. You know, you said you've done something with kids. I want to know how the kid reaction. So probably Islam. My father's got a lot of friends from different communities. My father's got Muslim friends and non-Muslim friends, or Christian friends. How did they react? And that would be really interesting for our viewers.
I think it has been a help. Obviously, we've spent time in Bangladesh. They live in Tower Hamlets and been to school in Tower Hamlets, which is a mixed school. So they do have friends of all different kind of ethnic, religious and family backgrounds. But I think to see their parents doing that, both my wife and I, doing that, it shows that it's a worthwhile thing. It's an important thing. It's not just something that's for school, but is for life. Everybody is made in God's image. Everyone is special. Everyone is worthy of respect and honour, no matter who they are, no matter what their background. And we should do that and be happy to be friends with all kinds of people. So thinking of the dragon boat racing, that was great for them to see that in a way, in practice, as we splashed about and got very wet and looked stupid. But to do it with your children and have
kids
fun together,
it, don't
exactly,
they? Yeah.
It was a good thing.
It's a way to take a back on you. Oh,
yeah,
you've
exactly.
been doing that to me, let me do it to you
exactly.
now. How many kids were there? Children were there? How many?
There was about 40 people in all. So probably
wow.
about 20 families.
Yeah.
Yes, about 20 families.
Yeah.
And I think what was really good is that, like I said earlier, sometimes you can be about a competition, you know, how can I be better than the parent? But actually bringing families together, saying, actually, this is what Baz does with his children, this is what Sabs does, this is what Rob does with his children. Actually, you know, I can maybe do that with my
That's
children.
Great. That's a great word you used, actually. How can we help them to rise the standard of morality and respect and mixing with? What can we, what do you think we should do?
Say,
how do we get our kids
yep.
arise the standard?
Yep.
Of speaking to people,
yep.
socializing with people,
yep.
meeting people. What do we have to do, you think?
I think doing these things, just being a part of your community. There's so much going on in our community. We are so blessed to be in Tower Hamlets. There is so much happening. There are so many groups trying to do stuff and bring people together. And I think it's just being a part of that and going out to these things and just stepping out.
Do you think we prize enough our kids? Like, if they do something good, do you think we... You know, say amazing and straight away we give them kind of gift or something like that. Do we think we do enough?
For me personally, I try to.
As a community?
As a community, it's very hard for me to speak up for a community, but within myself, I definitely see the need to kind of praise my kids, not for what they do so much, but for just for who they are and who they've been created to be. And just to praise them, just say, actually, you are kind of fearfully and wonderfully made. You know, and rather than... And just to encourage them in that and just say, you are going to be a blessing to others.
Mm. Oh, that's great. But Brother Brown, do you think we do enough? As a community, I'm talking about Bangladeshi community, do you think we do prize our kids? Like, if they do something good, we give them a gift or say, well done. Or so. Do you think we do enough?
Not really. Well, I normally do what I tell my kids. If they do something good, I tell them, if you do something good, Baba, I'll take you to Nando's, or
okay.
I'll take you to PFC, I'll take you to, you know, kebab shop, and they go, yes, and then they start doing good things.
Do you think
you
could do that when he's about 14 and 13?
Not
he's
really,
only nine, he's still a baby.
I know, that's the thing, I'm not really sure, no.
Because I remember, you know, like when your kids are growing up, it's like he's becoming an adult. So you're talking to your adult now. You have to give him that respect and space. And he's not that little boy anymore.
Yeah.
You know, it becomes something else. And he would say, no. You have to be ready for hearing, no, okay, all right, let's find a different way to do it.
Yeah.
If we don't, then it's an issue. You can't be so radical. Say, no, what do you mean, no? Mm. You live here, you can't, it doesn't work. I remember my kids were growing up. My oldest is 21 now. When he was 14 and up to 15 or 16, in that level, that time was, I was thinking, what shall I do now? I mean, I have to use a different tone, and I'll respect him, I'll get him into the table, and we'll talk about it beforehand. Mm. So he plays a role, so he doesn't take opposite ideas.
Yeah.
And It is difficult, believe me, it's difficult. Yes. Because, you know, used to hearing our kids saying, no, no, I think that's good, let's do it this way. Mm. Yeah, you think you know better than me, all right. Okay, let's do it. Mm. Remember, let's do it. But it's culturally, because I think we need to do a lot more. If our kids doing something good, we say, brilliant. Mm. If they do something bad, say, no, you can't do it. Mm. I'm not going to do it as well.
Yeah.
So I'm smoking. I'm saying, kids, don't smoke. But I'm smoking.
That's bad.
That's bad.
Yeah.
I'm having pan. They're saying, don't have pan. I'm having pan.
I'm not having pan.
I'm not having pan. has anyone offered you pan?
Several times.
Shada?
I mean, ekba khai.
Really? Yeah. You tried once? Yeah. I wish someone could tell my mom about that. It's addiction, right?
Yeah.
You can get your cancer. Mm. And a lot of people are suffering because of that.
That's right.
Pan, especially the shada one, the soon, the white stuff. Yep. And you get cancer in your mouth.
The tobacco shada. Mm. Oh.
Yeah. Mm. Okay, so what do you think we should do to change the attitude of most probably, like when I was growing up, my father was a really straightforward person and he doesn't do any wavy. He says it and we do it. We used to, all right, fine, no problem. You're my dad, I'll do it.
Hmm.
But that creates something else. The love, you know, your heart is only finds the people you like.
Hmm.
You can't force it.
Yeah.
It's very, very important what we do with that, with our parents.
Hmm.
So I think we need to do a lot more. I think,
especially,
you said you learn a lot of things from your friends and all that stuff. That's amazing. The more we mix with people, it's an easy way of learning.
Hmm.
I genuinely believe that, actually.
Yeah.
So if your kids say to you, my kid says it, my younger boy, he's 14, he'll say, Abba, I'm not Bangladeshi, I'm English because I'm born here. And I don't argue with him, honestly. I don't argue with him. There's nothing to argue. Mm. He's born here.
Yeah.
He said, you're Bangladeshi because you're born there, man.
Mm.
I said, would you respect because your father is from that place? Yeah, I'm fine, but don't tell me.
Yeah.
You can't win the argument. Mm. So I think that's a fair argument as well. That's a fair argument. Okay, so we were talking about solutions.
Mm.
We talked about a lot of issues that how do we find a solution. So we don't have many, but if someone wants to contact you regarding football and their trips and their social stuff, it's amazing stuff you guys do.
Thank you.
What do they do?
I would, we do it through the schools.
Sorry, my voice is.
It's okay. So we do it through, we want to do it through schools. So I would say if you are interested in doing the football, then ask in the when we started the project, we met had a lady called Alison who's I think has been on this show, and she enabled us to start what we did, and then her connections got us into other schools. So we went to Marna School, Old Palace, we went to Seven Mills, Cubit Town, Globe School as well. They're the main schools that we've done kind of worked with, and it's through those schools and through the parental support worker that the project's been able to grow so much. So they deserve a lot of the credit for what's happened. Because they've told the fathers, they've gone out and met the fathers in the playground, told them what's happening, and they've kind of sent the fathers to us. So they've kind of sent the key people in the school who have then began, dads then have done next stage, and then gone out and told the other dads who have began to bring people in, who have then brought other fathers in. So I'd say go to your school, talk to your teacher, talk to your parents or support worker, sorry, and then please let us know, and we'd love to be to kind of get involved with the project where we're running, or to maybe set one up in another area, and see if we can do that.
The amazing stuff you guys do, honestly, it's amazing stuff you guys. It's a life-changing stuff you guys are doing. Has that been covered by media? Do you guys do anything in the media, like we're doing this, come and see us, or take pictures, or something like that? Do you?
So when we had the East End Life, we had photographers come down and take pictures. Okay. We've done a few things, but we haven't gone out that far out on that side. So it's been in the paper, the local paper. It's been in the school newspapers. Yes.
Mm.
Robert, if I ask you, sir, how do we take the activities to our kids, next generation of people? Could they look at us and say, wow, look at that, that's great, they're playing. How do we take it to the next generation? How do we teach them?
Well, I think it is being a role model, like you were saying about smoking or pan. You can't say someone tell someone to do something if you're not yourself doing it. So I think it's helpful to be a role model that backs up what you're saying as well. I think it's, in a sense, in terms of bringing up children, it's about their heart, and like you were saying about as your children have grown older, the way that you relate to them changes. We must always be kind of, there's a book I read that's very helpful called Shepherding Your Child's Heart. It's kind of helping your child to make the right kind of choices as they grow older, as they develop, as they change. And those choices are about having the right kind of character and maturity to live in this world in the right kind of way. And as parents, we make mistakes. We get it wrong a whole lot of the time. But if we show our children what we're trying to do and also say, we've got that wrong, and we need God's forgiveness from this, just like you do, and that's a learning point in itself. We want our children to grow up, in kind of Christian terms, loving God and loving their neighbour. And if we're not doing that, then they're not going to be doing it either. And this is one great way of doing that, particularly loving our neighbour, saying it doesn't matter who we are, where we're from, we can just be together.
Do you think we have enough role models as a fathers? I mean, do you think we have enough good fathers to... Because people are getting away from the marriage and all that stuff. You know, it's not fashion anymore. Not being married is more fashionable than being one. It's really, really, it's so sad. Yeah. It's really sad.
So I don't think we can look to the media or celebrities or famous people for our role models in that kind of way. I think, as Gareth was saying, it's kind of looking to one another, being open and honest with one another, so that I can say, oh yeah, Gareth's doing that with his children. And that's something that I would like to copy, not to be better than him and kind of get into competition and comparing and making myself feel better, but being open, knowing people well enough that you can learn from them so that we can be role models for one another. I don't think we need to look outside to the media or celebrities for our role models. And I'd say too,
But it's always going to be there, isn't it? That's the attraction, actually. Yeah. That's the attraction.
But it's helping them to see that, why do you think that person is a good role model? Will that actually help them? Will that person help you to be the best person you can be or not? And it's evaluating things, not by money, by status, by material possessions, but by more important things to do with your heart and character.
But perhaps if I ask you, sir, how do we balance a approach? Means you have your identity, who you are. Whether you're Christian, you're Muslim, or you have no faith, that's who you are.
Yeah.
But you could work with everybody, you can live with everybody. You don't have to sacrifice your identity. We're no one asking that. But we as a human being, we're going to work together. So how do you balance that? Because some people might be saying, oh, what's going to happen if I take my kids or playing with... They would be confused, more confused than ever. So how do we balance that?
Just be yourself. Be yourself, whatever you are. If you don't discriminate, I don't think anyone else would discriminate you. You should look at yourself before you look at someone else. That's what I think. And if I'm good to everyone, then everyone else would look at me and think like, he's a nice guy as well. And if I'm bad, then I suppose they're going to look at me and think I'm bad guy, bad person probably.
Because most of the time people assume things.
Yeah.
Maybe he's got a different hairstyle or blindly. Yeah. But that's probably not the case at all.
Yeah,
we assume things a lot. That's how humans are. They look into other people's faults a lot.
That's right.
So what would you say to your kids?
Tell them? Be yourself. Don't judge anyone. I always tell my kid, never judge anyone. If you're going to judge, you're going to have to judge yourself first before you judge someone else.
Brilliant.
And that's what I always say,
Right. What would you say to your kids?
I think
honestly, really.
What Baz says, I think it's very important that they don't judge others and they give everyone a chance.
Yeah.
You know, I think love is very, it's a big word, but love is so important. You know, just teach your child how to love. And that comes from us first, as Rob was saying, you know, how we need to set the example ourselves. You know, are we showing our kids how to love?
Especially, as a Bangladeshi community, I could criticize myself. So as a parent, so you've got a wife, you've got a husband, and you've got kids. Kids wants to see how do you connect with your wife and how do the parents work together, how they decide things together. And this will always come in the head because you are the people who they love the most, without any kind of doubts. So like, you know, Islamically, we should help each other, we should cook together, we should run together, we should play together. We almost everything is like a partnership thing. But unfortunately, we don't do that.
Yes,
it's true, isn't it?
True, yeah.
Are we taking our culture more than the guide of the God? You know, like guidance of, you know, from the Islamic religion.
Yeah.
Somehow something took it over.
We have to change that. We have to interact more with our wife in the kitchen, you know, dishes.
Do you know how to cook?
We don't do
that. How to cook?
I don't, unfortunately.
Yeah, okay.
Only thing
she's
I can,
watching
I
you.
Can cook is omelet.
That's a good thing.
She knows that, by the way.
Would you make tea for her?
I do sometimes. Yeah.
No, that's great. Honestly, she we need it, to yeah. challenge a lot of things.
Yeah. Yeah.
If we don't, we are going backward.
Mm. Yeah.
You know, we are human. We are human culture. I mean, positive culture.
Yeah.
Negative things will come into it. Like people are seeing something else and deciding maybe we are like that.
Yeah.
Mm. You know, some places you will see kids are worshiping their parents. Mm. That's overdoing it.
Yeah.
You who you are, and you only do what you think is right and just, and you play a positive role in it. You don't have to worship me because of my kids. You have your own say. You have your own way. I have my own way too.
True.
So sometimes what happens is blindly, it doesn't go very far though. That's the thing. Once you become a blind follower of something, you will break somewhere.
Mm.
And then that will destroy forever. So I think it's amazing. I know a lot of people might criticize, oh, religious people are like that. But they don't get to see what we do.
Mm.
You know, they don't get to see how you're planned in your home.
Mm-hmm.
They don't get to see how you treat your kids and your family and where you do it. It's not easy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of sacrifice are needed into it.
Mm.
You know, we don't go nightclub, we're not going to drink. It's a lot of things we want to do it, but it's not sensible.
Mm.
We think I could put more effort in my family. I want to bring them as a role model to the community. We want to see a difference in it.
Mm.
Yeah.
People don't get to see that.
Mm-hmm.
They will always judge you with a negative line of somebody maybe like using religion as a name.
Mm.
That's the issue with this.
I think you mentioned the word sacrifice, and I think that's really true. It's being willing to sacrifice myself, my desires, my wishes for others. Actually, my wife's concerns should come before my own. The well-being of my children should come before my own comfort.
Mm.
I shouldn't just sit on the sofa and want to relax if my child needs help. Or if I need to talk to my wife because I've upset her, but I'm ignoring her because it's much easier not to deal with that problem, although it's not because I should be repairing that relationship, I should be willing to be other-centered and sacrificial. Sacrifice is the right kind of word in that
Why
way.
Do you think people doesn't know about the way we do things at home? Because I'm a religious person, you're yourself a religious person. We will do all that stuff. I cook at home, I try to do this for her, because I want to please God.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing else. I don't care what people say. I want to please God and I want my kids to be same.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't respect their mother, when they grow up, they'll have something else in their head. Mm-hmm. It's true, isn't it?
True, yeah.
So how come the amazing concept of, you know, family concept in our religion, actually, both religion, and it's not been, you know, people doesn't know about it. I just find it shocking.
There's probably a lot of reasons. I think some reasons are, in the past, some people in all kinds of religions have gone wrong, and that's then raised up as, oh, that's awful for all religions. So one bad apple kind of has said everything is wrong. I think people don't want to do what God says. Our hearts need changing in that way. Our hearts need to be transformed, as the prophets in the Bible talk about, before we can ever want to do what is right. We don't naturally want to do that. And it's interesting, there's a verse in the Bible that says, folly, foolishness is bound up in the heart of the child. It's important for us as parents to teach wisdom, but also for God to be transforming someone's heart to want to do the right thing. We can teach as much as we like and show an example as much as we like, but God still has to be at work in someone's heart to make them want to go along the right path.
Brilliant. Thank you for sharing that. I want a story from you about your football team. A success story and difficult story. So if you pick one up.
I'm
sure you've got plenty.
So if we start with a difficult was when we started probably. When we started, we were in the Marion Richardson School, and the football pitch there is in the winter is not the best. It's very, when it gets rain,
it's the first time
it's
very
slippery.
One to use there. He's doing the difficult one.
it's very slippery. And when we first started, there was six of us. Myself and a guy called Phil, who's from the E1 Community Church, and there were four dads from Marion Richardson School. And the first session we ran lasted 10 minutes. A couple of dads, their English was not very strong, so trying to talk to them was very difficult. Fitness levels of the group was very low, so this is why the session only lasted 10 minutes. And we finished after
I hope they didn't come wearing longi.
And we finished after the 10 minutes, and it just felt, this is just not going to work. But we asked the fathers, you know, do you want to do this again? And they said yes. Some of them didn't look too pleased about it, but they were like, yes, we will. And we came back the week after, and we did it again, and it began to improve. We played for longer, the conversations got longer, and a couple more people came. And we came back the week after, and it just slowly began to change. And then eventually we moved from Marion Richardson School and went to the park. And then we invited a couple more schools in the local area to join us, and the numbers began to grow, and just things began to change.
I remember playing fortified.
Yeah, you remember.
I remember.
And it was.
Yeah.
That's amazing, man. If you didn't, if it wasn't there,
we didn't give up. We didn't give up.
It wouldn't work.
Yeah, every Thursday we didn't give up.
A success story, please. One.
Success.
It's just all of them are success.
Actually. Everything, actually, yeah. It's just bringing the whole community together. Mm. It's just a success. We're like a family, you know. Everyone, we know each other. Everyone, whoever their background from, we know them now. And we're just like a family, you know.
Mm. So do you have anyone come negative and it became positive?
Yes, there is.
Pick one up,
always
not names.
No, there could be some negative, and next week they would come and apologize to me, or us, or in the group they would apologize and say, I'm sorry, I didn't mean that, this and that, and then we're going to move on. We normally do move on. We'll probably have some arguments on the pitch, and then next thing we shake hands and then just move on. Just a moment of madness sometimes. We get angry. Football is all about your passion. It's a very passionate game. Everything's in there, so very hard to...
Is Robert, he's a good player. Is he?
Oh, he's a fantastic player.
Where does he play? Where does he play? What's his position?
Mainly goalkeeper, yes.
Oh, really? I'm only joking.
No. Their main goalkeeper.
So what skills do you need in the goal?
He can play right, left back as well, yeah.
So he uses left hand most of the time.
Good,
you want his goalie, are you?
I like going in goal because then I don't have to run around so much. Okay. Too old for running, but I should run around more, so I try not to go in goal as much as I have done.
Did you play in Bangladesh?
I didn't play in Bangladesh the last time I was there. I played a lot of badminton, but 20 years ago when I was there, I did play with some people of my age. I was the only one with trainers, so I had a bit of an advantage, but yeah.
Because they're not, in Bangladesh, they're fanatic about it.
Oh, they're so much better than me at badminton.
They play all night, maybe?
Yeah, very impressive. Very impressive.
What was the weather like back home when you were there?
We really enjoyed it. So Sylhet's a lot nicer, I would say, than Dhaka, for all kinds of reasons, and other parts of Bangladesh. And it's generally a little bit cooler. We never felt this is so overwhelming a climate to live in. Sylhet town, I think, is a nice, bright town, and it's not
overcrowded.
It's not compared to Dhaka, and I think you've only got 10, 15 minutes, and you can be out in the tea gardens, in an eco park, and enjoying something of the countryside. So we enjoyed living there. Yeah.
So if I ask you, what was your favorite food in Bangladesh?
I'll give you my son's favorite food, which was dimbuna.
Dimbuna better. Okay.
I liked goro mangshu and katalbisi. That was all good.
Goro mangshu and katalbisi. Buna or lots of shira?
Buna.
Spicy, hot?
Yeah, that'll do.
Okay. Can you cook it?
Cow meat.
I can't cook it, but my wife can. She's very good now. Yeah.
Okay. Can you khaita for adia? Okay. When you were talking to people, were they laughing a lot?
Oh, mostly, yes. Yeah. I think it's a novelty for a foreigner to try and speak Sylheti language. So there was a lot of laughing and commenting. But it's also a good thing to learn someone else's language. It's showing respect for them. And I think for Sylheti language particularly, people have said, well, it's just village or it's slang or it's Cockney. But just from some of the research of mine and our friends, there's a real rich heritage to it. There's an old alphabet that's been forgotten the last 80 years or so. And it is a proper language spoken by 10 million people worldwide. And that should be respected. And language is part of who we are. God has given us languages. And that's an important part of our identity and shouldn't be denied or squashed in any way.
So you are campaigning also about the Nagrik language itself. Mm. It's amazing to know, because the first time I saw the letter you showed me, I think you're more Bangladeshi than myself, honestly. So what's the interest behind? What's your first personal interest behind?
I think partly it's living in tower hamlets. Okay. And so just being part of a community that's got lots of different people, many of whom I didn't always understand their language if they're first generation immigrants, and so just wanting to communicate with them. Partly through being in our church and doing meetings with mosques on religious issues, and not always being able to communicate very well, and wanting to be able to communicate what we feel to be important to us about Jesus, about Isa. And my wife also was a GP, wanting to have be able to communicate with her patients. So it's a communication thing, but particularly for people to understand what we feel to be good news for all nations, that Jesus is the one that can bring life to all kinds of people.
That's great, actually. Do you know any silly songs? Because you've learned how to... any poem?
I have not learnt off by heart any poems or songs, so I cannot perform one, thankfully, which is a good thing. But I could read some badly to you. Yeah,
that's great. You know, it's you put me in shame, you know, because I can't. you know more Bangla itself than me.
Anyone, actually, even me.
No.
So if I ask you, do you feel, you know?
I feel a little bit ashamed myself that he knows more reading than...
Yeah, but your English is better like him. What do you think?
Exactly.
Why do you feel bad?
Exactly.
Well, that's one positive thing, yeah.
Exactly.
Okay, I was only joking. I don't know how good that is, you can tell. Honestly, okay, you got 1 minute for our viewers to say the positiveness that you guys are doing together, and why do you think they should involve your stuff?
Basically.
Okay, so the stuff you guys are doing together, football, trips and everything, why do you think it's good? And why do you think they should get involved with you guys?
Yeah, because we're doing that for the last 5 years, and I've enjoyed it so much. I lost so much weight as well. It's a good thing because you don't do exercises regularly, and if you do these kind of football things, then you can have a good exercise, basically, and it's good fun as well. Yeah.
Good. Okay, that was very short, though. So, you take his time.
I'll take his time. I think for me, it's just being able
That's the camera you're watching, yeah.
Being able to meet Baz, and not just Baz, but 60, 70 other fathers who, if I didn't do this, I wouldn't have been able to meet, and not just play football with them, but to sit down and have a meal with them, to go out on a trip with them and just experience life together, to meet their children, to meet their families, to be able to even go into their homes. If we didn't do what we did, we wouldn't have had this opportunity to do that. So for me, it's just been a real blessing to meet so many amazing people.
Do you want to shout out to your kids, say anything?
To my children,
yeah, go on.
To my children, if they see this, Abigail, Daniel, and Janaya, and Michelle, my wife, I miss you, and I'll see you soon.
It's only half an hour. You're missing.
No, I know. You put me on the spot.
Okay, so just pulling your leg. Robert, you're 1 minute.
I know. I've thoroughly enjoyed Father's football. I've found a new bunch of mates, and that's introduced me to a load of other people as well within the community. It's broken down barriers. It's got me a little bit fit in between injuries. People laugh at me, I laugh at them. It's a fun time together. And I think it's just helped bond people who otherwise might be a bit suspicious of one another, and to break down barriers. I think it's been a good thing. It's a fun thing, and it's a friendship thing. It's a good thing to be involved in.
Fantastic. Before I went to you, actually, do you really remember any point in incentive? I'll be very interested to know. It's the sound itself. It's amazing. Okay, how about Amashunar Bangla? Not very similar to you.
I cannot do that. No.
Okay, I'll let you off. Okay, anything to your kids? Just say shout out to your kids. If you want to.
One of my children today, when I was talking with them about what we were going to be doing, I was going to be doing this evening and talking about football, and how jokingly I said football is the answer to everything. And one of my children said, no, football is the answer to absolutely nothing, unless the question is, what is the most stupid thing in the world? So hopefully, I've shown you, I won't reveal which child it was that said that, hopefully we've shown that football can be a helpful thing for many people.
Brilliant. No, I'm so glad you guys made the time for us, inshallah. Dear viewers, we had so much stuff, actually. They're doing amazing stuff. If you are free, not doing anything, I want you to come and join them. You know, it's amazing also. Yeah, amazing to see they learn so much together, actually. The bonding, like Baz was talking to you, I could see his body language, the way he looks at you, the respect he has shown. That's amazing. Even you guys, just like in the living room, we're talking to each other. This is amazing. So it only works when you work together. That's the beauty of it. And a lot of our young people in this country, we don't speak Bangla anymore. You know, that's another thing. You have put us in the spotlight. So next week, I'm doing a show on how to learn Bangla. So that would be interesting. And dear viewers, I think we should tell others who we are. We shouldn't be shying away from our identity. You know, we can learn Bangla too. If Robert can go in Bangladesh and learn Bangla, just to communicate with people and something he believes in to share it. That's amazing. We need to respect that. Yeah. Whatever we have, if we think it's good, we need to share it with everybody. So if you have little time, we need to do that. But one thing I've learned from you guys as well, like, if we come together, we can change things. We can change things. The barriers are there. You know, racism's still there. The bullying's still there. The negativeness still there. Extremism's still there. And how do we come out of these things, man? It's crazy, killing us. Look at those ruling are coming nowadays. Just because we are away from each other, so people are abusing and lose, you know, taking a weak point and saying, look, see, they're not working together. That's the problem here. But it's not the case, is it? Especially people of faith. I think we need to come out and share our commonness. You know, we have a lot of things in common. You know, probably you've seen it in my Facebook. I had him. I'm so glad a few of the priests came to our house last night and we shared tea, coffee together. And when they left, it was like your brother's going away. Someone you know for so long. And I remember one of the things how I changed was Nico. And he changed my way I see things. And he became one of my best friends. And I say, last week we had an interview as well. So, the viewers, we can change, and we should change, and change for better. If we said anything wrong, please do forgive us. And see you next week, inshallah. Make dua for us, and we make dua for you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.